Next one is batch processing, and that's a little bit more entailed in some ways. But the idea is that, are you guys familiar with the task scheduler at all? Windows task scheduler? There's a Windows task scheduler tool that you can schedule when a task happens. IT uses it a lot for to update your computers kind of thing. But I'm using it with Revit. And basically, this is a more complicated example. I'm not going to lie to you. But the idea is that, and I'll walk through it, is that you basically use the Windows task scheduler to schedule when you're going to print the PDF, say 2 in the morning every Saturday. I have to run a first of all, let me explain something. Autodesk made Revit so you can't run it. You can't do something in Revit unless it's running. So this is really the only way you can batch process offline in some way in Revit that I know of. We're using an EXE, and all the EXE does is grab a config file that has all the information to print a PDF, and I'll show you in a second. And then it launches Revit. When Revit launches, another an application add-in that I created basically launches when Revit launches, right? Like I've shown you 10 times so far. And then it grabs that config file, it deletes it from a temp folder so it doesn't keep running it. It prints the PDF. Let me go through it real quick here for you here. And again, it's not, it sounds more complicated maybe than it is in some ways. Let me just get rid of this add-in file here so it doesn't run. It's not faster. It's just the fact that you can run it 2 in the morning. You don't have to be around when it runs. Well, that's the thing. I open it up detached, but all works that's open. Yeah, believe me, I have to take that into account. So the idea is that if you run what's called a Windows task scheduler, so if I type in task scheduler, and so every Windows computer has it, you may not realize it, but it's there, and you can see that RIT probably runs it a lot. If I create a new task, I'll just call it auto print for now. And I'm gonna cheat a little bit, but I go to triggers. If I say I wanted to run it weekly, every Sunday at doesn't really matter. I'll just say 6. That's fine. Hit OK. So I run every Sunday at a certain time. Now I need to give it an action. I mentioned that it has to run an EXE first to launch Revit. And again, it's a workaround because of Revit's limitations. But this is the EXE, and you'll have the EXE. You have this in GitHub. EXE. Now, one thing I got to show you quickly is what it's going to run here. Let me see here. Let me go to this guy. No, let me go to the right folder here. It's hard coded to a certain folder right here. So really, the script file is here, and everything in the script file is going to be used. I have a little dialog box that I created to look at the script file easier. But the idea is that, again, you specify the sheet set name, the print set name, in this case, the full file path, and where you want the PDF output file to be. That's what's in the config file. I commented out this one, but you can also do it in BIM 360 if you get the GUID for the project and the GUID for the model. But in this case, we'll just do it for the file we've been using so far. So if I grab the this file here, and we, yeah.
Is that GUID change?
The GUID only changes if you recreate the central. So it's I'm not using the Forge API for any of this, so it doesn't run. I do have to get the GUIDs if somebody recreated the central. But so script file goes there, and basically that's really it. And if I hit OK, if I run this guy, what's basically going to happen, and let me go back to this guy here. This is going to run. It's going to run this guy. It's going to copy that config file to this temp folder. Sorry for the confusion here, but let me make this bigger for you. It's going to copy the config file to a temp folder. Once Revit launches, our add-in is going to grab the data from that config file, delete it from that temp folder, and print the PDF. And I'm going to show you that right now. So if I go back to here for a second, let's go to that temp file too while I'm thinking about it. So you see a copy of the temp file. Right now it's empty. So if I run this guy here, I just created. It's a complicated example, but I thought it was an important one to show you. That's one reason why we're going. You know, it is a little bit of a complicated one. So I'm running that. I'm running it now instead of waiting for the timer to go off. But that EXE I showed you is running Revit. All it did was launch Revit. And if I go back into that, think about that text file. It's already gone, actually, so it doesn't really matter. Okay. So Revit's right now. Revit's launching. It grabbed the information from that config file, and it's going to open up that file and print that PDF. That's what it's doing. This runs for us every week, every Saturday, on five projects. So it creates. So no one has to manually create the PDFs for those projects. At our firm, we have a VM that runs 24/7.
Okay.
So it has to run, right now it runs in that VM. I have them all running on that VM. So it does have to be, computer has to be on when it runs. And so it's going to print, it's basically going to print out that PDF, the PDF, and then it's going to close Revit. That's really all it's going to do. Let me see here, let me find that example. That's the bridge, that's the middle one, but here's the one that has the code for it. But again, I'm not sure how deep down this rabbit hole you want to go right now, but it's going to print out that PDF, it's going to open that file. Again, this is a complicated example, I know. It's grabbing the data from that config file, and it's going to open up the file. In this case, if it's a BIM 360 model, that's going to open it up that way, but if it's not a BIM 360 model, it's going to open it up detached. Where's it at? It's going to print the PDF. It's going to open it up detached and then print the PDF. But that's all it's going to do, and it's going to close Revit. That's a tough one to show you in some ways because it isn't an easy one to show you. But right now, it's still processing that PDF. It's only four sheets, but it is processing it. But when Revit disappears, the PDF will be in this in a dated folder. See, it created it here. Just created actually and closed Revit. As you can see, Revit closed, created this folder, and created this file. It used the name of the actual file for the print set name. As you can see, that's our file we've been using the whole time. But it happens 2 o'clock in the morning. See, no one's bothering with it. It just does it on its own. But that's something that there's one event that makes this work, and that's called the idling event. And that's something that I mentioned the other tool that this tool here that can launch Revit and open a file. It uses the idling event to do that too. And that's the only event that can make all this work.